So today again we will see the characteristics of different organelles. Okay, so we have already seen the three characteristics in, if you will refer my part 5 of the video, we have seen that why there is a growth in living organelles, why the living organism they respire. Okay, why respiration is necessary, why they show growth and why they need food. Okay, so we have already seen the need of food, the need of growth and the need of respiration in living organism. Now the fourth point that we are going to see today, three we have already discussed in part 5. For those three you can refer my part 5. Fourth is that its excretion happens in all living organisms. Okay? Fine, I will be telling you what is excretion. Excretion takes place in all living organisms.
Plants
but not seen in animals, but not as the way that is seen in animals. Okay, so the excretion, process of excretion, the mechanism of excretion in plants is a bit different as compared to animals. Okay, so in animals we have seen that the food we take, suppose we have taken food, further what happens? Some part of it is utilized by the body. Some waste are excreted out. Okay? Now in plant, this was in animals. This is the procedure in animals. Now if we talk about plants, the mechanism in plants are little bit as seen in animals. Because animals eat food, some part of it is utilized by it. Form of a stool or something like that. And in plants, part. Okay, and second, they remove the waste product, and that is called as secretion. Okay, so this how we got to know that excretion takes place in all living organisms. It takes place in plants also, in animals also. The only thing is that the mechanism in both is little bit different. Okay, plants have their own way of excreting the waste products. Animals have their own way. Okay, so excretion is clear. Just go through these two points of the plants, two conditions in the plants is occurring, so that I can move further. Okay. So now we will see the fifth point, that is the fifth characteristic of an organism. Do all organisms respond to stimuli? I will be telling you what is a stimuli. Okay. So do all organisms respond to stimuli? Okay, stimuli. So if you see around some examples, like if you suddenly come in contact with some sharp object like a thorn, suppose you are going and some plant is there which is thorny or bushy, and you come in contact with it, it comes here. Okay, or you are barefooted, it comes near your foot. How you are going to respond? You will say something, ouch, or something. So what is that? That thorn which has given you pain was acting like a stimuli, and the response you gave in the form ouch or something was the response to that stimuli. Okay, you hurted yourself with a thorn. Thorn was a stimuli, some external object that hurted you, and you have responded in a form that either you will remove your hand from there, or you will say ouch, something. Okay, so that was your response to that. Similarly, how do you feel when you see or think of your favorite food? Okay, suppose you love eating chips. So how you are going to, if you think of it, or you somewhere you get that thing, you will say, oh wow. Some response you are going to give, or some mouth-watering dish that you like. So some response you are going to give. So that food acts as a stimuli, and your reaction for that food is your response to it. Okay? Similarly, if you move suddenly from a dark place to a bright sunlight, suppose you are in a dark and you just go in sunlight all of a sudden, what happens to your eyes? Have you ever noticed? Your eyes shut themselves automatically. When you go in sun, your eyes will shut like this automatically. So what is that? That is again you respond to the stimuli, that is a sunlight. Okay, so it was a natural response. It's naturally happening to you. Okay, because you just wanted, you were in dark, and now when you went in a sunlight, you just wanted to adjust yourself from dark to bright. Okay, so your favorite food is there, and you are responding to that. Food is acting as a stimuli. If you have hurted yourself from a thorn, thorn is acting as a stimuli, and you have responded to that. And the other situation, like when you go in sunlight from a dark, all these are what? All these you are responding because there has been some change in your surroundings. It's not normal as you were. Okay? So respond to a change in your surrounding. Okay?
दैट चेंज कैन बी ऑफ एनी टाइप. आपके सराउंडिंग में कोई भी चेंज आया और उसके अगेंस्ट आप रिस्पॉन्ड कर रहे हो. ओके, दैट चेंज कैन बी ऑफ एनी टाइप. टाइप यू आर रिस्पॉन्डिंग. सब इफ यू आर क्रॉसिंग अ रोड एंड ऑल ऑफ अ सडन सम कार कम्स, व्हाट यू डू? यू जस्ट स्टेप बैक. You just step back or you run ahead quickly. What is that? That car has acted as a stimuli and you have responded that you just need to save your life. Okay? So, this is a response to a change in your surrounding. Surrounding mein aapki koi bhi change ho raha hai, to aap uske against respond karoge. Okay? So, all of us respond immediately in such changes. कोई भी change होगा, we will respond suddenly. Okay? That's a sudden response. So respond to a change in our surrounding. That respond is sudden. Sudden. Respond is sudden. Okay? So that respond is an immediate. Respond is immediate. Immediate means all of a sudden. All of a sudden you are responding. Okay? So change in our surrounding that makes us to respond to them immediately is called stimuli. That change in our surrounding which makes us to respond immediately is called stimuli. So if you are being asked what is a stimuli, the first thing to clear is stimuli. Okay? So change in our surrounding which makes us to respond them is called stimuli. Okay, so this was stimuli. Now the question is, do all organisms respond to stimuli? We have seen that human beings respond to a stimuli. How these human beings respond? I have given you 2-3 examples. If you are crossing a road, all of a sudden a car comes, or if you are being hurted by some thorn and all, if you get some food, if you go in a sunlight from a dark. So all these are the response to a stimuli given by human beings. Now the question is, do the other animals also respond in a way we respond? We human beings respond to stimuli. Does other animals also respond in the same way? So for this, I will give you a very good example. That is, if you remember, so if we talk about other animals, we find that animals also show the behavior like the way we respond. Okay? So if you serve food to any of the animals, you can take an example of a cow or a dog. When you give them food, if you give a chapati to a cow or if you give a chapati to a dog, how does they respond? They just come towards the food. They want to have it immediately. Okay? We find that suddenly they become active. Suddenly they become active after seeing the food. Okay? So when this is what? How? Why they become active when they see food? Because food is a stimuli and they are responding to that stimuli, that they are getting active to it so that they can eat up that chapati or that food which you have given. Similarly, if you move towards a bird, what do you see? You will see that those birds fly away. They just run away. Why they run away? दिस इज बिकॉज दे वॉन्ट टू सेव themselves. फॉर अ safer साइड दे मूव अवे. दे थिंक दैट इफ यू विल गो towards them, यू विल कैच them. यू विल दे विल बी caught. सो दे मूव अवे. सो दोज words, दे आर giving a response to this stimuli, and that is we are moving towards that. Okay, similarly, if we see any wild animals, they also run away when some light is flashed towards them. Suppose in night, if you travel on a road, you must have seen that when your car light flash on those animals, they just run away. Okay, so this is again, what is that? That flashlight is a stimuli for those animals, and they are responding to those stimuli by running away. Similarly, what is going to happen if you move towards a cockroach? They just try to hide themselves to a place or where they can't reach, or somewhere behind the cupboard, or somewhere where there is no light. Okay, so all these are response. So we have seen that human beings respond to stimuli. I have given you 2-3 examples. Similarly, animals also respond. Animals also respond like human beings. Okay? So we have seen how cow, goat, or dog, they respond if you give them food. The first example is the respond to food. Secondly, I have told you that if you go towards the bird, these birds will run away. Second example was the birds one. Third is if a flashlight falls on any of the animal, they run away. Flashlight. And fourth example which I have given is that of cockroach. You must have seen cockroach begin to move immediately to hide themselves. Okay, so cockroaches, if you are being asked in the exam to narrate with example how animals respond to stimuli, you can give any of these examples, the food one, the bird, or flashlight, or the example of cockroaches, how they start hiding to the places where there is no light, or it's somewhere in the kitchen, or somewhere in the cupboard, or some interior parts. Okay, so we have seen that plants, animals respond, human beings respond. Now the question is, do plants also respond in the same way? So now we will see that whether plants respond to stimuli or not. Okay, so what is the response of plants to stimuli? Okay, so we have seen that animals respond to stimuli. Now the question is whether plants respond or not to a stimuli. So you must have seen that there are many flowers of plants that blossom only at night. Okay? They do not blossom at the daytime. Wo day mein nahi khilte hain. They blossom only at the night. Okay? In some plants you must have seen that those plants, some plants of the flower, they blossom at the night, and when there is a sunset, the flower closes, and again in the night it opens and closes when there is a sunset. Okay, so this type of plants, like example you can take mimosa is a very commonly known plant which blossoms only at the night, and in layman language it is called touch me not. Okay, respond to stimuli, that is you can say they respond to the change that is occurring in their surrounding. Okay, so the first category of a plant you can see is that some plants blossom only at the night. Okay, they bloom or they blossom, you can say, only at the night. And what happens when there is a sunset? It closes. The flower closes. Okay? Example you can take, there is a flower known as 9 o'clock. Okay? So that 9 o'clock plant is a very good example, which blossoms at the night and when there is a sunset it closes. In some plants, what happens if you touch some plants, if you touch them, the leaf closes or folds. Some plants, when we touch, the leaves closes or gets folded. Okay? Example is mimosa, also called as touch me not. Mimosa or touch me not. So its name is only touch me not. It means that the plant or the flower says don't touch me. If you will touch me, I will close. Okay? So these are some of the examples of the response of the plants towards the change in the surrounding. So here you have seen the change is that what is the stimuli which is occurring here is the night. When there is a night, the plant responds, means it blooms when there is a night. In this the response is given there. In this, if you see what is the stimuli that is taking place, that is you touch them. When you touch, when human being, when some birds, some insect touches the leaf, how it responds? It closes. Okay? So we have seen that all living organisms respond to stimuli. How animals, they respond to stimuli. I have given you some of the examples of cockroaches, cow, buffalo, dogs, when you give them food and all. We have seen how human beings, they respond. We respond different times, differently. And we have also seen that plants also respond to stimuli. If you are being asked in the exam to explain with example, these two are the examples and you can explain how these plants, they respond to stimuli. Okay? So it means that all living organisms respond to stimuli. Okay? So fifth, we have seen their response to stimuli, the fifth characteristic. Now the sixth characteristic which we are going to see is that do all organisms reproduce in their own kind? Okay? Does all organisms reproduce in their own kind? Does all organisms, they reproduce their own kind? It means that does all living organisms, they give a birth. Reproduce means here birth. To reproduce, to produce again. Reproduce, re means dubara. Produce means paida karna. So dubara apne kind ko banate hain, apne jaisa hi ya different rehta hai. Okay? So have you ever seen the nest of a bird like pigeons? Most of you must have seen the nest of pigeons. So many birds, what they do, in fact you can say most of the birds, they lay their egg in their nest. Birds kya karti hain, apne egg jo hote hain wo apne nest mein lay karti hain. Okay, some of the eggs they hatch, and when they hatch, what comes out? A bird again comes out from that. Okay, a baby bird comes out. So animals mostly reproduce their own kind. Animals reproduce their own kind. So the first example you can take of a bird. What does the bird do? Bird lays egg in their nest. Okay, so when they lays egg in their nest, the egg gets hatched. Egg hatched, and when it hatches, a baby bird is produced. Okay, so here you can see birds are reproducing their own type. Those chicks, you can see if baby birds, those chicks grow in a bird. Okay, again, so the mode of reproduction in different kinds of animals is different. Here you have seen that bird lays eggs. Okay, other animals are also there which lays eggs, like the snake is there. The snake also lays eggs, and from that egg a baby snake comes. If you see fish, most of the fish, they gives egg, and from the egg a fry comes. Fry is the baby fish. Okay, lizards you must have seen. Lizards are the examples. Okay, so these lizards also, they lay eggs, and from that a baby lizard comes. So here we have seen lots of examples of the animals which lays eggs, and from their eggs the young one comes. Okay, so in all these animals, they lay egg, and from the egg comes their young ones. Okay, so this was one mode of reproduction, how they reproduce. This mode was from the egg, that from the egg a young one is coming. But there are some animals, as I have told you, that there are different modes of reproduction in different animals. So here was the egg, but some animals reproduce their young ones not only through egg, but they give birth to young ones. Okay, they give birth to young ones. Okay, so egg, we have seen birds, snake, fish, lizard are the examples. Now we will see the other type of the animals which reproduce themselves. Young ones.
So the first example is human beings. We know that human beings, they give birth to their baby. Okay. The women in human, they give birth to baby. Other animals are like cow. Cow also give birth to young one, that is their baby. Dogs are there. Dogs also give birth to baby. Okay. And in fact, some fish are there which give birth to baby. You will get to know. Okay. So, like this, there are thousands of examples of the animals which give birth to baby, but not they give birth to the egg. Kangaroo is there. Okay. So many animals are there. So we have seen that there has been two categories of animals which give birth. Okay, how they reproduce themselves. They can either reproduce themselves by laying egg, or they can reproduce themselves by giving birth to young ones. Okay, so two categories we have seen. In the one, they are giving the birth to young one, and in the one category of the animals, they lay eggs. Okay, so this was about animals, how animals reproduce their own kind. Now the question is, does plants also reproduce their own kind? Okay, so does plants reproduce their own kind? So the answer is, like animals, plants also reproduce, but the mode of reproduction is different. Okay? Plants also reproduce, but it is different from that of animals. So many plants reproduce through seeds. What happens if you grow seed? The seed germinates and it becomes a young plant. Okay, many of we grow seeds in many plants, and which can germinate and it grow into a new young plant. Okay, so seed plants, example you can say coriander is there. We show the seed and it becomes a coriander plant. Okay. And in some category of the plants, they reproduce the parts other than seed, not seed. एक में तो हमने seed लगाया और seed से वो germinate हुए और एक plant बना, ठीक है? कुछ ऐसे categories जिसमें seed नहीं, पूरा plant लगाया जाता है. Plant को आप as it is लगा दीजिए, they will grow, they will reproduce their own kind. Okay? So some other parts are also there. यहाँ पे तो seed as a part use हुआ. Some other parts में जैसे potato buds जो होती हैं, जो eyes type का आपको दिखेगा potato में, वो जब करते हैं हम लगाते हैं. So first category was seed. Second category comes like potato with a bud. You must have seen that potatoes have got some eye-like structure on it. That is called bud. So if you put the potato bud under the soil, it is going to grow into a new plant. Okay, so the second type of example is a potato bud that grows into a new plant. Okay, so we have seen that the different parts of a plant can be grown. Some plants, they reproduce themselves as a whole. Okay, so living things reproduce more or less similar to their own kind. Okay, through a process.
reproduction. It matters that there are different ways of reproduction in different organisms. Some animals gives eggs, some animal gives birth to young ones. Some plants they germinate through the sheath. Some plants we cut the section. In further classes when it will grow, you will get to know that grafting is a method to grow a plant, and there are different kinds of method how from one plant to another plant can be grown. Or बहुत सारे ऐसे plants हैं जिसमें sheet को spread किया जाता है soil में जो field है और उस seed से वो grow करते हैं. Okay, so we got to know that all organisms reproduce their own kind, whether it is a human being, animal or it's a plant. All of them reproduce their own kind. Okay? So now the next thing is that do all organelles move? Okay? Thus there is a movement of all organelles from one place to another. Okay? So if you remember in chapter 8, the previous video, you can see the previous video, previous chapters video, you can see in the chapter body movement we have discussed various ways in which animals move. We have seen the movement of different ways how animals move. They move from one place to another and their body also moves. Okay, so we have seen that human beings, they move using their legs. Human beings move using legs. Okay, then we have discussed different animals like cats are there, cows, goat, dog, buffalo. They also move using their legs. Okay, so if you talk goat, cow, cat is there, all of them, buffalo and all, they move using their legs. Then we have seen other animals also, like snake. We have seen they use their whole body to move. Okay, so like this, different kinds of animals uses different parts of their body. Some crawl. Okay, some animals they crawl. We have seen birds. Birds uses their wings to move from one place to another place. Means they fly. Okay. We have seen cockroaches. Cockroaches, how they move? They have got legs also. They have got wings also. Okay. So they can use their legs also, their wings also. So like this, we have seen number of animals that move from one place to another using different parts of their body. कोई अपने wing से एक place से दूसरी fish है, fish will move using its fin. Okay, so there are different types of body parts like legs, whole body can be used, wing can be used, fins can be used. So different body parts can be used and there are different types of movements. Some crawl, some walk, some run. Okay, so different things are there. So in human beings, in animals, we have already seen how the movement takes place. Now the question is, does plants move? The way, does there is any movement in plants? The way we have seen in human beings and animals, does these plants, they move?
ये रूट तो फिक्स
होगी आपकी सॉइल में, ओके, इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू मूव. अ पर्टिकुलर प्लांट
They respire means they breathe.
organism. And there are some certain characteristics of living organism that makes it a living organism. Next thing is that, okay, they have got so many characteristics, they respire, they move, everything is there in living organism. But these living organisms, they die one day. एक दिन वो मरते भी हैं. ऐसा नहीं है कि जो लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म है वो अमर है, वो कभी मरेगा नहीं. नो, दे विल डाई वन डे. सो देयर इज अ सर्टेन पीरियड ऑफ देयर लाइफ स्पैन, जिसको बोलते हैं लाइफ स्पैन है. एक पर्टिकुलर लाइफ स्पैन होती है हर लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म की, और वो अपने पर्टिकुलर लाइफ स्पैन के लिए ही दे आर गोइंग टू live. Okay, after that they will die, because organisms die. Particular types of organisms can survive over thousands of years, some can die in 100 years, some in 50. Okay, so there is a different lifespan of different animals, but mostly we reproduce, animals reproduce their own kind before dying. Okay, so apne डाई करता है तो दूसरा वो छोड़ के जाता है. दैट इज द इकोसिस्टम, इट इज रनिंग, द सिस्टम इज रनिंग, बिकॉज इफ यू डाई यू लीव योर यंग वंस, यू रिप्रोड्यूस योर ओन काइंड. ओके, सो वन सिंगल ऑर्गेनिज्म मे डाई विदाउट रिप्रोड्यूसिंग इट्स काइंड. बहुत से ऐसे भी होंगे जो कि अपना कोई काइंड रिप्रोड्यूस नहीं किया एंड दे गॉट अ अर्ली डेथ, बहुत अर्ली डेथ हो गई और अपना काइंड रिप्रोड्यूस नहीं किया. बट बहुत सारे एनिमल्स होंगे जो अपने काइंड को रिप्रोड्यूस करके और तब डेथ होती है उनकी. ह्यूमन बींग्स में भी सेम चीज है. दैट्स व्हाई रिप्रोडक्शन इज देयर, दैट्स व्हाई लाइफ इज देयर, और इस तरह सीरीज लाइफ की चलती है. एक डॉग्स ने बहुत सारे पपीज को बर्थ दिया. अब ये डॉग डाई कर भी जाएगा तो इसके लिए 3 पपीज स्टिल अलाइव है. नाउ दिस वन इज गिविंग 5, this is giving 5, this is giving 5. Now if all these 3 are dying, no matter, these are there. Okay, so like this life continues. So we have seen in the chapter 9 the living organisms and their surrounding, that life is very beautiful, and we have seen different characteristic of living organism. So this was all for part 6, and I also complete my chapter 9 here. Okay, so if you have any confusion, description box where the mail ID is being mentioned. You can mail us for any of your difficulties, or you want any other things to be explained, or any question, any queries there, you people are welcome to ask us. Okay, so thank you so much. Thank you for watching my video. Please give a like button if you like the video, and also subscribe our channel Ollie Scholars so that you can get the daily updates of the videos which we are uploading daily. Okay, and in the description box there is a link of our app is also given. Ollie Scholar has got its app also. You can go and download the app. There you are going to get very interesting videos, PDF notes, even you will get MCQ questions. You can solve them, you can see where you will stand, and if you are interested for live classes, we conduct that also. So thank you so much. Thank you for watching my video. Please go in the description box and go through the link of the app. Thank you so much. Please subscribe our channel.